So 13 years ago, I was living in New York. I was 22 years old. I was working very long hours and I could not afford takeout. I was spending too much on rent. I had made a poor decision on how much to spend on rent, over 50% of my take home on rent. And basically what was happening is I was barely breaking even every month. And I did a calculation and I calculated that I should spend about $20 to $25 a day on food. And when you included breakfast and lunch, that just did not leave enough to order takeout, which could easily be $20, even if you're getting something like a $10 burrito. When you add in the tip and the delivery fee and everything, it did not pencil out. So I suddenly realized, okay, I need to learn to cook. And I really did not know how. I had been very lucky to have a family that took really good care of me and provided dinner every night growing up. And I went to college where we had food trucks and I sort of couple things together, go to cafeteria, et cetera, Hillel. And all of a sudden here I was, 22, didn't know how to really make very many things. So I decided to learn how to cook and I didn't really have a ton of time to learn how to cook. I was working very long hours. I would get home at like 7 or 8 at night. I would still have a lot of work to do. So I'd need to create dinner somehow and maybe stop at the grocery store on the way home, cook, clean up, and get back to work. And what I was finding is I was getting into bed at like 10 or 11 at night with my big cookbook. And basically I was like months into this. I would get in bed at 10 o'clock exhausted. And I was 2 months into this and still reading the section on soups. This was not working for me. I didn't want to make soups. I just wanted to have a normal dinner and I didn't know how to put it all together. So over the course of the next multiple years, I tried many things to learn how to cook. I watched a lot of cooking shows. I spent a lot of time on YouTube. I looked at blogs. And basically every single time that I spent time researching cooking, I just became increasingly frustrated. I felt like, okay, I just read this whole recipe. It has 15 ingredients. Is this going to take 45 minutes to make? It sounds like this beautiful dish. But then what am I going to do with all these leftover ingredients? What am I going to do with the herbs and these random items that I purchased for this, you know, glamorous dish from some cuisine? And I couldn't figure out how it all fit together. I think this went on for a very, very, very long time, and I experimented a lot. I started going to the farmer's market more. I started getting a few staples into my repertoire. I would order takeout here and there. I'd go out to dinner. I would eat at the office, honestly, a bunch. Additionally, the food I was eating at the office was a certain style of cooking, sort of like new California cuisine, and I would come home and be like, I want to cook like that. Like, how do I make simple food that's sort of elevated with herbs and spices and just like good, tasty ingredients? So I started really thinking about like, how do I build a lifestyle that can make food like this, that where I'm not relying on takeout, or I'm not eating at the office all the time and I'm cooking for myself? Additionally, I was single and I wanted to develop a skill set around cooking for one. And most of the recipes out there are for more like 4 to 6 people. I was very frustrated. Fast forward to this trip I took to New York around that time, and I visited my friend Anna, and she was going to make dinner for her family that night, and she brought me along with her to do her grocery shop. And it was just this eye-opening experience. We went to the fishmonger, then we went to this little corner store, somewhere else, I can't remember, picked up a couple things here and there. I was like, what are you making? And she's like, I don't know. It's like potatoes and some tomatoes and some fish. It was just very glam the way she shopped. And I realized she was shopping without a recipe in mind, and that was how I wanted to learn to cook. I wanted to be able to cook without recipes. I was sick of looking things up, you know, looking at some ingredient in my fridge and being like, oh, how do I use this up? And then looking at recipes, all these ads and all these other ingredients I didn't have, and I didn't want to go to the grocery store. I found looking for recipes to be very frustrating, and I couldn't figure out how to incorporate recipes from cookbooks into my life. Maybe for a project here and there, like having some friends over or a special date night or something like that. You can look up a recipe and plan around it. But for your day-to-day cooking, you know, you get home at 7:30 at night on a Tuesday and you're wiped. The last thing I want to do is start looking through the internet, being bombarded with ads, and then looking at a recipe where I don't have half the ingredients. What I wanted to be able to do was look into my fridge, see what was in there, and put something together. So this is all to say, I started thinking about creating this course, Cooking Without Recipes, because that's what I wanted to be able to do. Cook without recipes. I wanted to feel confident in the kitchen. I wanted to have flow. I wanted to put on music and reach into my fridge and whip things up. And I wanted to have this sort of lifestyle where I would always have food in the fridge that I could make things with, but I wouldn't have a ton of waste. I didn't want to waste food. I didn't want to waste plastic. I didn't want to waste money. I just wanted it to be efficient and economical and easy and fun and sort of glamorous and exciting and creative and chill. And so basically, I spent the next year thinking about this all the time, spending a lot of my free time working on this Google Doc, cooking without recipes. I wanted to create a system of cooking where you could learn your basic skill sets, but then mix and match them together to create, you know, things you would love. And so I thought, you know, I was looking through all these cookbooks and realizing so many of these recipes are just so duplicative. Like there's six different types of braised chicken in some of these cookbooks and, you know, different flavorings. But what I was thinking is, what if you just structure this and you learn what it means braised chicken, and then you separately can learn about spices, and then you can decide what type of braised chicken you want, whether it's Moroccan or Greek or French. It's still the same technique. It just has these mix and match of flavors. And I started realizing that basically almost all these cookbooks are recipes where you're sitting there like a robot following instructions of whatever that chef wanted you to do, but not teaching you how to think or how to learn or how to memorize so that you can do it on your own. And what's really exciting in cooking is when you make up your own recipe and it's exactly what you love. It's the spices you love. It's the saltiness you love. It's the amount of spice you love. For example, I really don't like spice, which people make fun of all the time. They say I must be a super boring person. And maybe I am, but you know what? I just don't like spice. It really is not comfortable for me, but other people love spice. And so whatever it is that you love, you should be able to bring to life in the way you cook. So that's the long way of saying, like, this is what this course is about. I was looking earlier today at my notes back from 2019 about this course, and I was looking at things like home ec syllabuses and these charts on YouTube. Where we're at now is about 80 lessons in. I'm going to pull it up, and you can see if you go to the Cooking Without Recipes course, you'll see the table of contents so far. I broke up the course into 8 modules, how to boil water, which I think is a great place to start. You know, why wouldn't you start with the beginning? How to cook with air, how to play with fire, how to wield a knife, the balanced salad, how to hack your freezer, lunch 2.0, and how to stride ahead. This section is still work in progress. It's coming along, but everything else is pretty close to done. You can look at any of these lessons. The goal is that nothing's repetitive. Everything is MECE, so mutually exclusive, cumulatively exhaustive. So you won't see much repetition. The goal is that you can go into this course, you can bop around, you can go in order, you can really do whatever you want, and you can fill in the gaps in your knowledge. I worked with a chef, April Word. She really helped vet this out, and she was just absolutely fantastic partner in bringing some of these lessons to life. There's a big mix of things here, everything from very basic things like how to blanch and chalk vegetables, to things that are a little more complex like cooking continuously, which is a meal prep method. In this video, we make 5 items in 1 pot of water in 1 hour. You're sort of adding things and then removing them. We also go into some fun hacks, like in how to hack your freezer. We talk about things like flavor cubes, where you can freeze things in ice cube trays that you can use for later use to add flavor to your dishes really quickly. It's just great to have a freezer stocked. You can get so ahead of things, so you're not starting afresh every single time. We go into things like how to select and care for lettuce and greens, how to deal with food safety like poultry. We're going to do a bunch more on grocery shopping and storing and picking produce. Basically, everything that's sort of the basics. My vision is that this can help inspire people to reduce their environmental footprint, to eat healthier, to save money, to save time, to enjoy cooking, to get into a flow, to feel confident, to have a date night, to cook for your friends, to cook a dinner party. I just have found so much joy through cooking. I want to share this with others. So that's all to say. I hope you find it helpful. If you have any questions or feedback at all, please email me. I'm Michelle at trylifeschool.com. Thank you very much. All right. Goodbye.